Tonight, TBR is out on the town, and our first stop is the marvelous musical, Porgy and Bess.
The performance at San Francisco's SHN Golden Gate Theater looks like Porgy and Bess, and it certainly sounds like it, but it's not. It's the Gershwins Porgy and Bess, a new take on an old classic. George and Ira Gershwin based this 1935 opera on the book, Porgy, by DuBose Heywood. It ran on Broadway for some 124 performances, starring Anne Brown as Bess and Todd Duncan as Porgy. Reviews were mixed. White critics didn't know whether to call it a folk opera, a jazz drama, or a musical. Black audiences didn't like the story. Set against the backdrop of Catfish Row in Charleston, South Carolina, they felt it was full of clichés, dope dealers, prostitutes, a poor crippled black protagonist, basically a beggar, just the kind of images African Americans were trying to escape in 1935.
What's really interesting is the black community did not accept Porgy and Bess in the early days. George Gershwin died in 1937, 2 years after finishing the opera. Ira lived until 1983, and he told me many times that he was bound and determined that this should only be performed by people from the black community.
And it was. It gave black actors, musicians, and dancers much needed work at a time when plays with African-American casts were virtually non-existent. The original tour even forced DC's segregated National Theater to open its doors to blacks. Wherever Porgy and Bess went, it seemed to stir up controversy.
One of the most interesting performances was in Europe in 1943, when an all-white cast performed the show in blackface during the Nazi occupation.
The 50s saw an explosion of Porgy and Bess recordings. Louis Armstrong and Ella Fitzgerald won a Grammy for their album in 1956. Miles Davis arranged it for big bands in 59. That same year, Harry Belafonte and Lena Horne released their own version. Then there's the film, directed by Otto Preminger in 1959. Sidney Poitier plays Porgy and Dorothy Dandridge is Bess. Diane Carroll, Sammy Davis Jr., Brock Peters, and Pearl Bailey rounded out the cast. Gershwin didn't like it. He said it was too much like a musical, and his estate had it removed from release in 1974. When word got out about the creation of a more audience-friendly Porgy and Bess, the critics had a field day. Stephen Sondheim wrote an op-ed in the New York Times accusing playwright Susie Laurie Parks and director Diane Paulus of dumbing down the original. They were adding more scenes, more dialogue, or more upbeat ending, and Sondheim thought it was blasphemous. But controversy aside, everyone agreed that casting Norm Lewis and Audra McDonald was brilliant. And when Gershwin's Porgy and Bess opened on Broadway in January 2012, the critics loved them. The show won the Tony Award for Best Revival of a Musical, and McDonald got Best Performance by an Actress. Baby, don't you cry. Alicia Hall Moran and Nathaniel Stampley are the latest incarnation of Bess and Porgy. Stampley is no stranger to Broadway. He played in The Lion King and The Color Purple. He has no problem with this version of Porgy and Bess.
It's a musical, and so for people that are a little intimidated and going to Opera House and seeing the full version, they're gonna come in and hear this glorious music, and they're gonna see parts of themselves in some of these characters.
Moran from California is a classically trained vocalist. She says she's honored to join the ranks of vocalists like Sarah Vaughan, Lena Horne, and Nina Simone, who have performed this classic. As for the critics,
people love this show. They love this show. The music is Gershwin, and that really lets us off the hook.
I got the sun, I got the moon, I got
the actors in this touring version are young, and they seem proud of these characters, not ashamed of them.
I learned from my mom to not let anybody tell me nothing. She also says, do not allow people to take your best stuff away from you.
It's a dream come true. Honestly, when I was in high school, I was in the opera chorus, and I got to hear Donnie Ray Albert, who's arguably one of the greatest porgies. And I thought, if I could ever grow up seeing that music like him, oh, that would be heaven. So here we are many years later, I'm living my dream.
We'll be back in a moment.